Okay, so we're here with Min, the CEO of Razer, one of the biggest brands for gamers now, for accessories. Hi, and welcome for having us. Can you tell us something that you introduced here at Gamescom about your latest products?
Sure, absolutely. So there are pretty much three things that we're showing over here at Gamescom. The first of which is the Razer Ouroboros. That was a product that we kind of announced last month in China, in Shanghai China Joy. And it's the world's most customizable gaming mouse. So that's the first thing. And we're super excited. Come by and see it. I think we'll have one of my associates kind of take us through the product. The second product that we have done a world premiere is the Razer Death Stalker. You know, it's what we call the world's smartest keyboard. It's got a dynamic adaptive tactile keys on the right side and a screen on the right side running all kinds of applications and stuff like that. So it's pretty cool. And the third thing is, the third product that we showed for the first time worldwide is the Razer Kraken. It's a professional gaming headset with a retractable mic, super comfortable, and it's the most comfortable headset ever. Three products.
Okay, thank you. I also heard that you're also opening the developer program for your new keyboard.
Absolutely. So the Razer Death Stalker has what we call the Switchblade user interface on the right side. 10 dynamic adaptive keys that shift and change to anything, and there's also a cell phone quality screen below. What we've done is that we've developed some of the most phenomenal applications on that. YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, whatever you have. But what I'm most excited about is seeing kind of ideas coming up from the community. Our motto is for gamers, by gamers. So what we want to see is try to get as many of these developer kits out there, and their SDKs, it's free, right? To our developers or gamers who are developers, and have them develop applications for themselves and for the rest of the community.
And what if these gamers don't have access to your keyboard, for example?
Sure. So if they have a really kick-ass idea, and if there are already developers, write to us, we'll send them a kit. And it's all absolutely on us. Because this is one of those initiatives that we want to kind of give back to the community and have them have an opportunity to get their work in front of the millions of Razer fans out there, too, at the same time. So write to us, you know, get the details from our website. We're here to support the community.
Okay. Razer is also, like for the Razer Blade, for example, is in North America now. I don't know if you can tell us anything when it's coming to Europe, but any ideas?
We always have ideas. But I think right now the issue is this. We thought we were going to launch the Razer Blade globally by the end of the middle of this year, actually. The problem was we did not expect so much demand for the Razer Blade. And in North America alone, we've only been able to kind of catch up with demand in North America. So fingers crossed, we are hoping maybe sometime next year. But no promises. Right now, we're just trying our best to match demand.
Okay, maybe from one final question. Because, of course, we're a tiny Belgium, and we use a SZERTY keyboard. Uh-huh. Like the French.
Sure.
Any ideas that you will also meet demand in our countries? Because, of course, the global keyboard combination is QWERTY, but we use SZERTY, but okay.
And it's pretty cool, though. I mean, there are times of which when I see a SZERTY keyboard, I'm like trying to find out how to go through them. But essentially for us, every single gamer in the world is important to us. Belgian gamer, French, German, etc. So what we're trying to do right now is we're trying to make sure that we have enough scale to reach as many of the gamers out there. Now, definitely we're exploring localized keyboards and key layouts, but it's a chicken and egg situation. So, you know, if there are Belgian gamers out there, write to us, let us know, work with our distributors, write to them, tell them that, hey, look, you know, we really want to have an SZERTY keyboard layout. They will come and our distributors will come to us and say, hey, look, you know, we've got enough Belgian gamers over here who are crazy about the Death Stalker and we really want to have a SZERTY keyboard. Then we go, cool, if we can make enough, definitely. The last thing we want to do is to make something that gamers don't want. And for gamers, by gamers, that's what we are.
Thank you for the interview and hope to see you next time.
Thank you very much. Thank you.